But it came a time when money failed. There become time, the Bible said, put no confidence in the flesh, but put confidence and faith in him. I'm going to share just this, and I'm going to get off here, and I want you to understand that. I thank God for my father and my mother. So many examples in life and what they gave me, and I use that to carry on and even to this day. I remember I was going through something one time, and I had some things and some secrets in my life, and I began to share with my mother a secret, and I gave it to her in confidence, and little come to find out that my mother had shared it with somebody else, and it got to the point where it really disturbed me. I was so surprised and shocked. I said, man, I can't believe my mama would go and tell this. You know, I said, well, you know what? I don't think I can even trust my own mother no more, because she'd go and tell what happened. I didn't want to tell nobody this here. So I was riding in the truck with my daddy. And as we riding in the truck, I began to tell him, I said, Dad, you know what? I said, I shared something with mom, and I can't believe she went and told it. I can't believe she went and told somebody what I said. He said, I just can't believe this. And I said, I don't know if I can trust her with anything, you know? And my daddy, as he's driving, he looks at me and he says, son, he said, that was a, he was from Cottonport, Louisiana. He said, son, there was a lady, had a son, a husband, and they worked on this farm. It was back in kind of little right after the slavery days, and there were sharecroppers. And says, one day she looked out and she saw her son up under a tree, and he had a shovel and he was digging something. And as she was digging up under the tree, the mother began to wonder, what is he doing? Look like he's burying something, you know? And so it says the son came back to the house with the shovel, and the mother looked at him and said, hey, you know, Junior, what's going on? Well, what you burying up under that tree? And he said, Junior looked at him and said, well, mom, he said, don't tell anybody. Please don't tell anybody. He said, mom, I killed the white man and I buried him under that tree. He said, mom, please don't tell anybody. And the mother said, okay, son, I won't tell anybody. And so she lay down in the bed that night, and said the husband come home, and the husband's in the bed, the wife's in the bed, and he looks at her, and he says, Ruth, what's wrong, Ruth? You're not the same. Something's wrong with your spirit. Something just ain't right. I don't know what it is, but it's disturbing me. I can tell. What is wrong, Ruth? What is wrong with you? You're not the same. Something is not right. And she says, baby, I hate to tell you. You know, I didn't want to tell you. I promised, well, I would never say nothing to nobody. But that boy of ours went out there, and he had killed the white man, and he buried him up under that tree. And he said, oh, baby, can't tell nobody. So he goes to work the next morning. He's working out in the field. And as he's working, so the boss man came over to him and said, John, is something, I don't know what it is with you, John, but something's wrong. You're not the same. You know, your spirit looked like something's gone. Look like, you know, you lost your best friend. I could tell something's wrong with you, John. Would you tell me what's going on? And says, boss, I hate to tell you, he said, but that boy of mine went out there, he killed the white man and he buried him out there under that tree out at our house. And it said, the boss looked back and said, what? He did what? He killed the white man. He said, a man took off in his truck and said, oh, no. He said, next thing you know, they got up a posse, came out to the man's house and got the man's son. He said, and as they was taking the boy off, he was passing him in front of the house. The mom was sitting there looking, and the dad was sitting there looking. He says, and the son sitting there with tears in his eyes, crying, and says, hey, I didn't kill nobody. He says that they drug him off. He says, and they went and they hung their son. He said, but then they went and they began to dig up the bones to find the bones of this white man that the boy had killed. He said the mother and the father realized that he didn't kill a white man. He had really, the dog had died and he had buried the dog. And he looked at me and he said, son, who can you trust? Now, I'm saying all that to say this. My daddy answered my question without answering it. He answered it in the form of a parable, just like Jesus did. He, in other words, I'm not going to tell you what to think. I'm not going to tell you what to do. But I'm going to give you an example of life. Now, whether this story is true or not, but you decide how you're going to live your life and how you're going to be. My decision was that I would still trust my mother, but I would know what to share with humans and what to share with God. And so I thank God for the way my father answered that for me, because he didn't tell me yes or no. He didn't say, oh, you shouldn't feel like this about mama. He didn't say you should, but he just gave an illustration, just like God does in his word. He gives us a parable and it's up to us to choose. Choose ye this day who you're going to serve. He's not going to make you. And he'll have the solution for every problem you got if you just give it to him. Call the prophetic prayer line and let God speak to you. Shalom. Shalom. And once again, shalom.